How can you got a fan play TV home and away? Outside of West Wolf, she goes for tonight, starting on the event. Like so, Les Ferdinand, Andy Sinton, Andy Eupy, Kevin Gallen, and whoever else is at the stands tonight. Ty Walton, obviously. Talking about the team and that in the decade of the 90s, our own experiences behind the scenes, on the pitch, the team, and obviously we were playing quite well at that time as well. Should be an interesting night. Hopefully a big turnout by the sound of things, and see how it goes. Hopefully I might be able to get a few words from some of the players. If not, no worries. We'll see how it goes. That's it. DJ Ranger, QGR fan place to be home and away, outside of West Chalk Studios for the Stars of the 90s QGR event tonight. I'm out of it, coming yours. I think I've had a place to be home away. West 12 Studios for the Stars of the Night event, sorry. I've got the one and only Clive Walton. How you doing, mate?
I'm fine, thank you.
How did you see the event, Dave?
Oh, a fantastic event. Well turned out. I think most people enjoyed the story.
Yeah, they were great stories, mate. From all of you. I mean, big turnout, as you say, great event. Hopefully everyone enjoyed it. Thanks to the club for doing the event. Thanks to you guys for coming down to actually share some of the experience that you have at the club. Hopefully you have many more of these events come down for the club, and big thanks to the club for organising it and for the players to come down. Any words for QGR fans out there, Clive?
No, just keep on supporting. Let's take the hours back to the promised land of the Premiership. Hopefully we've got, I don't know if it's a 5-year plan, but it might be a 10-year plan, but we'll get there one day.
Okay, thank you very much, Clive, for your time. And it's great hearing your story along with Les, Kevin and Andy Sinton. So thank you very much for your time.
Very well.
DJ Ranger, Clive Wilson at the West Coast the Stars of the 90s event at the West Coast Studio. You've got fans of players, home of we're out of it. Come on, you are. QPR fans and players TV, home and away. Just been at the West 12 studio for the Stars of the 90s event. Gaby, what do you think of the event tonight, mate?
Yeah, it's great, as always. It's nice to meet the players, the legends of the past.
Yeah,
brilliant.
And great story from the players as well.
Some
of the incidents.
And good insight.
Exactly.
Shows how football's changed from how it was back then to how it is now.
Mate. Alright, thanks for that. That's DJ Ranger, Gaby Ranganathan at West Hall Studio for the Stars of the Night event. Well done to the club for putting the event on. Quite a good turnout from the fans. Great stories from the players, and hopefully we have a few more events coming up in the forthcoming months and years, etc. So it actually brings the fans and players together again, like it has done in the past. Come on, you guys. QPR fans play TV home away. Stars of the Night event just finished there. Got a friend, Steve, aka Stony, Govins, mate. How you doing, mate?
Yeah, not bad.
Obviously, come down as a neutral fan to the Stars and with Govin.
Yeah, it's been a really good evening.
And obviously, I've spoke to you before at a previous event we've had down here. Are you a hidden QPR fan by the chance?
I'm not a hidden QPR fan, but I do have a massive soft spot for him because obviously, Govey goes to everything that is QPR. So
you're going to feel our pain as well.
And funny enough, there's a few of us now. My mum now looks at the QPR results. Our mate Steve looks at, and he knows absolutely nothing about football at all, but he knows what QPR are doing. So.
Okay, obviously I see a game Saturday as well. Steve does actually go to a few games now with Govin, and his other friends that go as well. With tonight's event, obviously I've spoken to you before at the event, the question of sport article, the last thing that had in this event venue as well before. How do you see tonight compared to the previous event?
I think it was really good. This was lovely because it gives you a connection with your ex-players.
Yeah.
Some fantastic stories in
there. Great.
Even for me, who's not a QPR fan, some great old football stories, which is just fantastic. And I think every fan really likes to hear.
Yeah.
What goes on in a dressing room, what goes on in a tunnel, you know, and just that. I mean, we all played football. We all love football. That's why we come to events like this. And yeah, we've all played for our own teams, and we kind of know that little bit of banter that goes on.
Of course.
It was great to see.
Yeah, and even though there's that saying which says, "Okay, we're going to change the stage."
And they kind of let it out a little bit today, so that was great.
Well, I'm sure there's more stuff. That
There was definitely stuff they were holding back. You can see the little glint in there every now and again that was like.
And
we can't say that.
Obviously, from the fans' point, there's a good turnout from the fans.
Brilliant,
How many there was in total.
Once again, you know, QPR has this great family atmosphere. You know, they even welcome me, so.
Well, yeah.
You know, and I'm a complete outsider,
From an outsider
really
point, if you notice that, then, you know, I mean, obviously, I'm sure if more fans want to attend, they have a limit on the capacity, I suppose. But, you know, if the interest was there. I'm sure they'd look at bigger and better.
I certainly think, you know, if you're a QPR fan, this is something you really should be thinking about coming to, because you know, it does support the Forever Ours Foundation. But also it just gives you a really good insight into your own club, so it's a lovely thing.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, some of the stuff that, you know, prime example, when they sit left the bench on Wednesday now, and what he was saying about how it actually unfolded and he went and then sending the club didn't or what he felt he should have been offered. As a fan, I don't recall remembering hearing that. We only heard certain things.
You get to write a few wrongs in these things, and that was really nice to hear his side of the story.
Now, whether the fans actually believe that, that's coming from the person's own mouth. Whether they're right or not, you know, obviously they're looking out for their best interests at heart, like we all do, like, no matter the shape or form. But thank you anyway, mate. Thanks for your time.
No problem at all.
And maybe see you once again at the next event.
I'm sure you will. Go be all
that. That's DJ Ranger, Steve, aka Stoney, go be Ranger Nathan's friend. I reckon he's a QPR fan, really. QPR fans, players and team, being home and away at the West Shore Studio for the Stars of the 90s event tonight.
We all ate leads.
We all ate leads. Our QPR fans, Players TV, home and away. DJ Ranger in the place. Not long in from the Star of the 90s event tonight at West 12 Studios. Another great night the club have put on for us, the fans, to enjoy. And for those who watched whatever they could, if it was online as well, I'm not too sure where it was going live. Great stories by the ex-players, by Les and the MP, Andy Sinton, sorry. And the MP was meant to be there, but he didn't turn up for personal reasons. Kev Gallen, Clive Wilson, great stories from all, and a great event yet again. So a big well done to the club for putting it on, in supporting the Forever Ours at the club, obviously along with the community and the trust, etc. Keep up the good work, club, and hope to have many more events, club, so fans can get to them as well. Big plus point, ladies and gents. I thought it was another great evening by the club at the West 12 Studio for the Stars of the 90s event. So I say well done to everyone involved behind the scenes, and well done to the players that's actually taken their time out and come and speak about their experiences throughout the 90s era at our club, QPR. That's myself, DJ Ranger, for QPR fans and Players TV, home and away. I'm out of here, coming you ours.